Recently, Zoom ne ki exclusively Vivek Oberoi se baat. In this conversation, he spoke about how disappointed he is because of the delay in the release of the film PM Modi. Chale, dikhate hain aapko ek small snippet of this conversation.
You in no way could see what Election Commission had a point there when they said that, you know, when a particular film, you know, a big film like that comes in, it has the power to influence people and votes might get influenced. No, so you didn't think there was a point there?
No, of course there's a point there. But the country works on a system, right? There's a law. So there's something called the Model Code of Conduct. Now, we went to legal experts before planning our release strategy. And everybody went through the Model Code of Conduct and said there is nothing against a biopic. So what was happening is that it's a very fluid document. You can keep changing it. I'm okay if you change it and introduce new laws, new rules. You've been talking to us, hearing about it in the courts as you've been a party to it. There's an oral submission in the court by the Election Commission saying that, look, as long as the censor censors it according to the Model Code of Conduct, we're okay. They're the authority. One night before the release of our film, in 40 countries, the prints are already out there, promotions are already done. One night before, you get a call saying you can't release the film tomorrow. That is retrospective application. So today, if Rudrani makes, you know, a crore of rupees and she pays 35% tax, tomorrow if the tax changes to, say, 55% and I call up Rudrani and say, now the tax has changed to 55%, so please make sure that for the last 5 years, you have to pay 55% on all the earnings that you made. That's called retrospective application. That is wrong.
So you felt you could, you clearly saw foul play. It was not Election Commission acting on its rules.
Yeah,
like that.
हम लोग बहुत confused हो गए because Election Commission बहुत बड़ी body है, एक institution है, उसको respect करना जरूरी है. लेकिन मन में तो सवाल आता है कि किसने कौन सा button दबाया कि suddenly Election Commission ने रातों रात अपना मन बदल लिया, आपकी पिक्चर रुकवा दी. पिक्चर रुकवाई ठीक है, उसके बाद बोला नहीं नहीं अब आपके प्रमोशंस भी हमको रोकने पड़ेंगे, उतार दो सारे प्रमोशंस, जितने ऑनलाइन है सब प्रमोशन उतार दो. ये क्या है? अच्छा, फिर हम अप्रोच किए, हमने कहा ठीक है, जहाँ जहाँ इलेक्शन खत्म हो गया है, जैसे महाराष्ट्र, गुजरात, थर्ड फेज, फोर्थ फेज खत्म हो चुका, देयर इज नो मोर इलेक्शंस हियर, नोबडी टू इन्फ्लुएंस हियर, यहाँ तो हमको कम से कम प्रमोशंस करने दो, पिक्चर नहीं रिलीज करने दो, प्रमोशंस. उसका भी कोई जवाब नहीं. तो जब उनको चाहिए तो रातों रात वो बात कर लेते हैं, जब हमको जवाब चाहिए तो वो चार चार हफ्ते खींच लेते हैं कि चलो इलेक्शन खत्म हो जाएगा फिर कौन सा. दिस इज आई थिंक रॉन्ग. दूसरा क्या होता है, हम इन्फ्लुएंस की बात करते हैं तो जैसे एक न्यूज़पेपर है, करोड़ों लोग पढ़ते हैं, एडिटोरियल कॉलम में किसी ने गवर्नमेंट को पैन किया, किसी की पॉलिसीज को पैन किया, किसी लीडर के बारे में कुछ कहा, वो भी तो इन्फ्लुएंस है, तो वो भी रोक दो. फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच आप कहाँ तक रोकोगे?
But criticizing the government for, by journalists will always happen because we are supposed to do that.
Journalist is a special citizen.
No. I feel
I'm also equal citizen as a journalist.
I agree.
Why can't I say it? So whether I make a film that's critical or not critical, see, today I want to ask you another thing. Logically, autobiographies and biographies तो सब जगह हैं. Still आप रास्ते पे जाके खरीद सकते हो, रेलवे स्टेशन पे जाके खरीद सकते हो, बुकस्टोर में जाके खरीद सकते हो. वो भी तो इन्फ्लुएंस करता है. उसको रोका किसी ने? This I felt was wrong. ये आप नहीं कर सकते हैं कि आप इन्फ्लुएंस. अच्छा, एक्ट में अगर कहीं लिखा है कि भाई इस दौरान कोई बायोपिक नहीं बन सकती, तो हम समझते थे, हम नहीं बनाते. हम बनाते या बाद में रिलीज करते या पहले रिलीज करते. आपने लिखा भी नहीं है. यू हैव नॉट बैंड इट इन एनी वे. व्हाट हैव यू बैंड इन द एक्ट? यू सेड नो एडवर्टाइजिंग. हम एडवर्टाइजिंग थोड़ी कर रहे हैं, हम तो पिक्चर बना रहे हैं. टू मी, आई एम अपसेट विथ माई सेल्फ टूडे फॉर नॉट डूइंग इनफ व्हेन संजय लीला भंसाली वॉज treated so badly. He's an iconic director of this industry. He's somebody who's made us proud in India and overseas. And he was thrust around, slapped around, people misbehaved with him at the time he was trying to make a film. Now, that to me is unfair and uncool. And if there are people that are uniting against a film, then there should be the film fraternity, which is a very powerful, very influential fraternity that should come together and say, hey, you know, in the South, I've done 4 films, one in each language. And the one thing I love about the Southern industry is they're very united. Across, whether it's Tamil, Telugu, they're very united. They stand together. If there's an issue, they stand together. They may have independent political views, they may have independent, but when it comes to cinema, they're always together. That's why the piracy rates are lower. That's why they were able to introduce the Gunda Act against pirates when there was physical piracy. We've never been able to do that. We're 20 years behind them in terms of the kind of approach that they've taken and the solidarity that they've shown.
Now, we all know the film PM Narendra Modi biopic jo hai, wo 11th April ko release hone wali thi, just when the elections were going to start. Aur kaafi controversy mein bhi ghiri rahi, jahan par election commission ne release ke ek din pehle decide kiya ki ye film ko release nahi kiya ja sakta, because we all know election commission is the highest decision making authority in the country when the elections are on. And it was their call ki elections ke dauran aap is film ko release nahi kar sakte, aur aapko ye film after the elections ko hi release karni padegi. Aur ab वो फिल्म रिलीज हो रही है 24th ऑफ मई. अब ये एक रात पहले कॉल करके बताना कि आपकी फिल्म रिलीज होगी या नहीं, कितना फेयर है या नहीं, ये नहीं पता, लेकिन highest making decision is the election commission aur usko follow karna zaruri. Exactly. In fact, the team had also appealed to the Supreme Court asking ki yaar hum bahut disappointed hain, and the fact that we have actually shot the movie in such a short span of time,
right.
We were hoping for this particular date only, lekin uske baad bhi, like you said, that there is a model code of conduct that was in action at that point in time. Jee. And the fact that the election commission took the decision ki hum is regarding ya koi bhi aisi biopic hum nahi chala sakte is waqt, the dates had to be pushed. And he spoke also about the fact ki kaise it has been disappointing as an industry, the fact ki yahan par a lot of people don't talk about controversial topics, and especially if they are directly not involved with them. He said ki south mein obviously things are very different, and looking at his perspective, obviously it was his big release after a really big time. There was a lot riding on this movie,
right? And Umang Kumar openly spoke about how you know, people release their films on holiday weeks or weekends, they actually target a special festival, lekin yahan par he was like, agar main ek पॉलिटिकल फिल्म बना रहा हूं और इलेक्शंस आ रहे हैं, तो मैं भी उसी स्ट्रेटजी से क्यों ना करूं, व्हाट इज द हार्म इन दैट. बट ऑफ कोर्स यहां पर बात थी अबाउट द बिगेस्ट डेमोक्रेटिक फेस्टिवल जो इलेक्शंस थे, एंड लोकसभा इलेक्शंस जो पैन इंडिया होते हैं, और इसीलिए जो है ये डिसीजन लिया गया था. हालांकि उनको ये भी कहा गया था कि आप इस फिल्म की प्रमोशन भी नहीं कर सकते, सो प्रमोशंस वर बैंड. पूरा मटेरियल जो भी ऑनलाइन था, जो भी ट्रेलर्स टीजर्स, सबको निकाला गया था. अब शायद इलेक्शंस के रिजल्ट्स के बाद, एक्चुअली इनफैक्ट लास्ट फेज ऑफ इलेक्शंस जब खत्म हुआ, उसके बाद ऑल द कॉन्टेंट हैज कम बैक ऑन सोशल मीडिया, सो नाउ दे कैन गो एंड प्रमोट द फिल्म. बट दे हैड टू वेट, द पॉइंट इज दे हैड टू वेट दैट वन होल ऑलमोस्ट अ मंथ for the film to release.
Well, talking about the support jo Vivek Oberoi ki movie ko nahi mila from the Bollywood industry, in retrospect he also mentioned ki kaise unko bhi realize hota hai ab ki in the past there have been a lot of controversial subjects, movies that have come out, probably पद्मावत के टाइम पर भी, जहाँ पर वो खुलकर नहीं बोले, जब उन्होंने सपोर्ट नहीं किया उस मूवी को. एंड नाउ बिकॉज हिज मूवी हैज कम थ्रू अ कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी, ही रियलाइजेस कि कितना ज़्यादा जरूरी है दैट एज एन इंडस्ट्री एवरीबडी स्पीक्स अबाउट ईच अदर्स इशूज एंड गिव वॉइस टू दैम. एंड एग्जैक्टली उन्होंने इनफैक्ट साउथ इंडियन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री से भी कंपेयर किया, एंड सेड दैट हाउ दे आर सो यूनाइटेड, एंड द फैक्ट दैट ही हैज ऑल्सो बीन अ पार्ट ऑफ द सेम फ्रेटर्निटी, एंड वही आइडियाज एंड लेकर जो वो चल रहे हैं, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू बेनिफिट हिम, एंड इट्स हैज प्रॉब्ली नॉट बेनिफिट द movies also in the past.
Well, dekhne layak hoga 24th of May. What is the kind of footfall? What is the kind of box office collection that this movie does? This movie fare well at the box office or no? Wo to ab 24th May ko hi pata chalega.